Hello everyone, this is Rahul Malhotra from SFDC's Top, and in this tutorial we are going to learn about bubble and capture phase of component events in detail. So if you have watched my previous tutorial, you must be knowing that we have made an application to calculate a total income, and this application works in a very simple way. Like, I can add another income, and I am going to add an amount like 5000, and I can add the income that is in the table, and I can calculate a total income by clicking this button. So, in calculating the total income, I am firing the event from the source component to the parent component, which is the total of all these incomes, and the parent component is showing the income here. So, the event handler at the source component is fired, and then the event handler at the parent component executed, and finally my income is updated here. So, this is the inner component section and this is the outer component section. So, we are going to learn more about bubble and capture phase and how they are working. So if you have watched my blogs, then you must be knowing that in the introduction, when I gave an introduction to bubble and capture phase before starting the YouTube series, and that in case of bubble phase, the event is fired from the source component, and it can be handled by the source component itself also, and then it move on to the parent component where it can be handled, and then to another parent component that can be handled, and then it again is moved to the up to the hierarchy to the root of the application. Whereas in capture phase, the event fired by the component cannot be handled by that component itself at that time, because the event directly moves to the root of the application, and then it follows the path to the source component itself, and it can be handled by any handler that is defined at any component in the path hierarchy. And finally, it can be handled by the component that fired this event, or you can say the source component where the event is registered. At the last, it can be handled by this. So we are going to learn about bubble and capture phase in detail in this video. So I am going to use the existing code only, and I am going to do certain changes that I have also mentioned in my blog. So I am going to follow these changes, and I am going to show you that how bubble and capture phase are actually working. Okay, so let's refresh this page once and let's move on to our code. So right now what's happening is, this is my container component, that is my parent component, and this is my source component where the event is registered, as well as I have a handler to handle this event. So in case of bubble phase, which is the default phase, this event is fired by the button which is calculate income or calculate total income, which is here in the inner component. The event is fired, so the event is fire total income component event. So this function is responsible for firing the event, and the event is handled by the handler, which is defined in the source component itself. So the handler is this, or a handler, and it is calling the handle registered component event function. You must be knowing all this if you have watched my previous video, and if you haven't watched my previous video and you know, I mean, you want a detailed explanation on all this, then you can watch my previous video as well as my blog too. So this is the handler which is handling the event that is fired by this component itself. So this is the source component which is firing the event as well as handling the event too. So in case of bubble phase, we got the alert first, that is event handler, the source component that fired the event, because we know that in case of bubble phase, the component that is firing the event can itself handle it. So we first got event handler and a source component that fired the event, and then finally we get event handler at the parent component, and finally the value is updated. So what the parent component is doing, it also has a handler for the same event, and it is calling the action handle total component event, and in this section we are giving an alert event handler at the parent component, and finally the value is updated. So to just confirm this thing, that the event handler, or you can say the event is in the bubble phase, is moving from source to parent, what I'm going to do, I'm going to make a very small change. In my event handler source component, I'm going to add event dot stop propagation. So what this method is doing, it will stop the event from propagating. So I can say that if I stop the event from propagating here, then it cannot move to this component and the handler cannot be executed, right? So let's check it once. So when I click on total, calculate total income again, I get event handler at a source component that fired the event, and boom, that's it. So I get this alert, event handler at a source component, because in case of bubble phase, the source component which is firing the event can handle the event itself before passing it on to the parent component, right? But I stop the event from propagation here only, so the parent component alert is not there. That means that handler is not executed. Okay, so one thing what we got to know, that the event, in case of bubble phase, the event is moving from child to top, that is child to parent. So let's move on to other instructions and let's see what we have to do right now. Okay, so we understood the bubble phase, and in case of bubble phase, we understood a basic thing mainly, that in case of bubble phase, the event is moving from child to parent. But what in case of capture phase? This is the main thing that we have to learn in this video. So one thing I want to say before moving forward, that bubble phase and capture phase are not associated by that particular event which is propagating throughout our application. Bubble phase and capture phase, these both the phases are associated only with the handler of the event, right? So the handler are executing in bubble phase only, and I can specify a handler to execute in capture phase by adding a simple attribute, that is phase is equal to capture. So in my source component, I added a phase equal to capture attribute in the aura handler, and in the container component also I'm going to make the same change, that is I'm going to add phase is equal to capture in the handler. So if you remember how our capture phase work, in case of capture phase, the component that is firing the event cannot handle it at the same time, but it can be handled by other components, and then at the end it can be handled by the component itself which is firing the event, because as the event is fired, it directly moves to the application root and then it moves down the hierarchy to the source component, and at the last it can be handled by source component, whereas the event can be handled by any component in the hierarchy. So let's check whether it is working or not, because now our both the handlers are working in capture phase, right? So I just want to make sure that I have commented my event.stop propagation method. Okay. So when I refresh the page and then click on total, calculate total income. Okay, so the event handler, the parent component is fired first, because in case of capture phase, the event directly propagate to the application root and it is handled at there at that point, and then it moved towards the source component itself. So the event handler at the parent component, and then we have event handler at the source component that fired the event, and finally my value is updated. So if you are thinking about this thing, that my parent component is updating the value, so I have the alert here and the value is updated at last. You must notice this thing, that my parent component handler is fired, and then my source component handler is fired, and then the value is updated, whereas the value should be updated at the parent component itself. So why this lag is there? Because the JavaScript is continuously executing our code statements. So the JavaScript just executed this alert, and then it sent the instruction to update the total income. And while that income is updated, the JavaScript executed the other alert also, because it doesn't stop executing the code. So there is some delay in, you can say, updating the value, but the JavaScript keeps on executing. But the flow is this only, that first the parent handler is executed and then the child handler is executed. So we got to know that when we are handling the events in the capture phase, then our parent component handler is fired first and then the child component handler. Even if the source component that is firing the event has the handler itself, but still the event goes on to the parent component first and then it moves down to the child component. Okay, so we got to know about handling the events in capture phase now. So what we can do right now, I just want to make sure that the parent component is handling the event first. As we make sure this thing in the bubble phase, we can just rely on this thing in the capture phase too by adding one thing, that is event dot stop propagation. So if my parent handler is executing first and I add event dot stop propagation here, then it should not move down to my child component, right? Because if I stop the event from propagating here only, then it should not move down to my source component, and the handler at the source component should not execute, because both my handlers are working in the capture phase right now. So let's refresh the page and check what happens now. So when I click on calculate total income, event handler at the parent component, great, and my value is updated, but event handler at the source component, alert is not fired. So this means that the event handler at the parent component is executed, but the event stopped propagating there, and finally my value is also updated, but the event handler at the child component, or the component which is a source component, is not fired, because I don't get the alert that event handler at the source component had fired the event. So I got to know two things right now. First thing was that in case of bubble phase, my event propagates from child to parent, and it can be stopped. You can say it can be stopped at child itself. And in case of capture phase, my event is propagating from parent to child, that is root to source, you can say. This is the most appropriate, you can say, words, root to source. And then it can be stopped anywhere in the hierarchy. I think I should copy this thing and I should paste it there also. That can be stopped anywhere in the hierarchy while moving bottom to top. And in case of capture phase, it is while moving top to bottom. So I got to know about this thing, and that in case of bubble phase, the event propagates from child to parent and can be stopped anywhere in the hierarchy while moving from bottom to top. And what is in case of capture phase, the event propagates from root to source, and it can be stopped anywhere in the hierarchy while moving from top to bottom. So the direction is opposite, that in case of bubble phase, it is moving from bottom to top in case of bubble phase like this, and in case of capture phase, it is directly moving to top and then moving from top to bottom. Okay, so I got to know about both the things, that in case of bubble phase, how the event is propagating, and in case of capture phase, how the event is propagating. But remember one thing, that the bubble phase and the capture phase are only associated with the event handlers, right? It is not associated with the event. I haven't specified anywhere in the event file that the event is going to propagate in bubble phase or capture phase. So how this is working? So I can say one thing, that the event is propagating in both the phases, but the handler is executed according to the phase, right? So just make sure about this thing also. So to make sure about this thing, now our question is that what will happen when I configure one handler to handle bubble phase and other handler to handle the capture phase, right? Because the bubble phase and capture phase are only associated with the handler itself. So let's say when one handler is in bubble phase and another handler is in capture phase, then what will happen? So what I'm going to do for this, that in case of lightning events comp 1, that is my source component, which is registering as well as firing the event, handling the event, you can say, I'm going to keep phase equal to capture as it is. Whereas in case of my container, I'm going to remove this phase equal to capture. Okay, so this is my handler, and there is no phase equal to capture in the container. So what is happening right now, that my source component is handling the event in the capture phase, whereas my parent component is handling the event in case of bubble phase. Okay, so when I'm going to click this button, let's say what happened. Event handler in the source component that fired the event. So this means that my source component handler executed first. Okay. and then even handle at the parent component. Okay, and finally my value is updated. So this is just similar to the initial thing that we noticed, right? So what I can say that my source component was handling the event in capture phase, whereas my parent component was handling the event in bubble phase. But still my source component is executed first, because however, the in case of capture phase, the events move from top to bottom, right? In case of capture phase, the events move from top to bottom, but still my source component handler is executed first. Why? So let's figure this out. What is happening here actually? I can form a solution according to the result that we are seeing, that what I can think of from this, that capture phase is executed first as compared to bubble phase, right? Because my source component is executed first, whereas parent component is executed after that. So I can say that the capture phase has more priority as compared to bubble phase. But let's not rely on my thing. Let's check it out again. Up till now, I have added capture phase to my source component, whereas I have added bubble phase to my container component. Now I'm going to do the reverse. I'm going to add phase equal to capture back here. Okay, let's just, why it is not saved. Okay, let me try once again. Lightning events comp controller. Okay, so I was adding phase equal to capture here. Okay, and in my comp 1, I am going to remove this. So now what I have done, that initially what it was happening, that my source component was in capture phase and my parent component was in bubble phase. So I noticed that source component was executed first, right? Whereas what I have done now, my source component is in bubble phase, whereas my parent component, that is this, is in capture phase. So my source component is in bubble phase and my parent component is in capture phase. When we know that source and parent are both in bubble, let's make a graph here. So source and parent both in bubble, then it is from bottom to top. And when source and parent both in capture, then it is from top to bottom, right? Because the parent component is executed first as compared to source component. So when both are in bubble, then it is from bottom to top. When both are in capture, then it is from top to bottom. And when one is source and one is capture, or you can say when source is captured and parent is bubble, then source component is executed first. And when source is bubble and parent is captured, let's figure it out what will happen now. So now my source is bubble and parent is captured. Okay, so I'm clicking on this. Okay, so the event handler at parent component is executed first and my source component handler is not executed. I think I have added stop propagation method, maybe. So let's remove that first. I think I have added stop propagation. Yeah, it's here. So let's try it once again. That event handler had a parent component, and then event handler had a source component that fired the event, and then my value is updated. So I got to know that when I am adding source as bubble and parent is captured, in that case my parent is executed first and source is executed after that, right? So in this case the parent is executed first, Okay, so what I got to know about this, that when the source component was in the capture phase, then this will execute it first. Whereas when the parent component was in the capture phase, then this will execute it first. So as a final result, I can say that capture phase is greater than bubble phase. I have already written there that we got to know from this is that capture phase has higher priority as compared to bubble phase, right? So what will happen if I stop the event from propagating in bubble phase? Because the capture phase is already run before the bubble phase, I should say, so it should execute, right? Let's check it out. Right now, when both the handlers are in different phases, then both the handlers are executed one after the another. While even if the source component executed first or the parent component executed first, it doesn't matter actually. So let's say right now my lightning event comp1 is in bubble phase. So I will stop propagating the event from here. So now the bubble phase is going to stop the event from propagation. So when I refresh the app and I click on calculate total income, so the parent component handler is executed first and then the source component handler is executed and my value is there, so no effect. So what I can say that the capture phase was executed first, right? This is why the capture phase was executed first. This is why when the event is stopped after the bubble phase, it doesn't propagate further, but it has already propagated in the capture phase. So this shows that the capture phase has more priority as compared to bubble phase. So to just make this sure, I'm going to add event.stop propagation here also. So in my container controller, which is executed first because it is in capture phase, I'm going to add event.stop propagation. You can check that this handler is in capture phase. So when I refresh the app and I click on calculate total income, so the event handler is at the parent component and my value is updated, but the event handler at the child component is not executed. So what I got to know from there, that first of all this phase handler is executed and then the event is stopped propagating and the bubble phase is not executed. So this means that the capture phase, I got to know one result from this, that capture phase, if the event is stop propagating in capture, then it will not propagate in bubble 2 because capture is executed first, right? And when the event is stopped propagating in bubble, then it will not affect, you should say, it will not affect capture phase because it is already executed in capture phase. So I got to know about when source and parent both are in bubble phase, then it follows the bottom to top hierarchy. When source and parent both are in capture phase, then it follows the top to bottom system. And when both the handlers are in different phases, that is one is in capture and one is in bubble, then the capture phase executed first and then the bubble phase executed. Why? Because when I added stop propagation to the bubble phase, or you can say to the component which is handling the event in bubble phase, then this stop propagation wasn't executed because this handler alert was there. Whereas when I added the stop propagation to my handler which is handling capture phase, then the effect is there and doesn't reach the you can say source component, or I can say the component which is handling in bubble phase. So to just make sure, I'm going to do it again. Let's comment this, and let's comment this too, just to make sure that you have understood this thing. I just want to say that my lightning events comp 1 is handling in bubble phase, where lightning events comp container is handling in capture phase, right? So when I go to comp 1 controller and I say stop propagating the event, so my event is propagated from parent and then to child. This means that parent component, which was in capture phase, is executed first, and then the bubble phase is executed, and then finally the event starts stop the propagation. So the capture phase is not affected by bubble phase anymore, whereas when I stop the propagation in capture phase itself and then I refresh the page, then my event handler had a parent component, and then the income is updated, but the event stopped propagating. So I got to know that the capture phase is affecting the bubble phase. So this means that the capture phase is executed first and then the bubble phase executed. So event is stop propagating capture phase, it will not propagate in bubble 2. It will not propagate anywhere. Whereas when the event is stop propagating in bubble phase, it will not affect the capture phase because it is already executed in capture phase. So you can just explore this more. I think I should suggest you to make one more component, or to make 3 or 4 components in the hierarchy, and practice bubble and capture phases and component events. So this is all for this video, guys. If you want to get the code, you can visit my GitHub repository. I have added all the code there. So you just have to go to laptop. Okay, so you guys have to go to github.com/rahulrota. Come on. Okay, so just have to go to my GitHub repository, and then from there you can go to SFDC Lightning. And from there, you have different branches. Sorry, this is not the repository that was of Lightning tutorial. So my repository for this is Lightning Events, Salesforce Lightning Events tutorial. And from there, I have different branches. So for the bubble phase code, I have all the code in component event bubble phase. Whereas for the capture phase code, I have added the code in component event capture phase. It doesn't contain much change, only it contains some simple changes, like if you visit comp 1, then it is handling the event in capture phase itself, like I have added phase equal to capture there. Just the small changes that I have made here also in front of you. And in case of controller also, I have added, you can say, event.stop propagation, and I have commented that. So you can test it yourself. So that's it for this video, guys, and I just want to make sure that, if you remember, when I had 100 subscribers on my YouTube channel, I created a component, or you can say an application named S-Object Converter, using which you can convert one S-Object record to another S-Object record. So I want contributors for this, because this is an open source project. I have released all the source code, so I want contributors. I have also added a single issue in this. So if you are willing to contribute, then please, please, please have a look at this code. I want you people to come and join me and contribute to this open source project. So if you need any help in this, then you can approach me directly on my Twitter handle. I am most active on Twitter, I think, as the whole Salesforce community. So you can go to twitter.com/rahulcoder. So go, you can go to twitter.com/rahulcoder, and this is my Twitter handler, where you can approach me if you need any kind of help. I'm there to help you, or you can just tag me in your post and I will be there. Okay, so in the next video, guys, we will learn more about application events, because there are mainly two events in Salesforce Lightning. First is the component event and second is the application events. So in the next video, we will learn more about application events. So this is all for the component events and the bubble and capture phase in component event. So I hope you like this, and just let me know your feedback in comments section, and for more details you can visit my blog and have a read there. Okay, thanks for watching. Bye bye. Have a good day.